Let's now discuss the last part of geometric design under the topic sight distance for horizontal curves. So here, what we mean by the horizontal curve meaning we're looking at the road in the top view, but this time it is in curves. For example, here in this figure, this is our roadway as seen on the top view and not the profile view. So the line here represents the center of the roadway, and this represents the obstruction. The M here is the clear distance from the center of the roadway, meaning if this is the obstruction, so this is the distance M from the center of the roadway to that obstruction. Then we have the S, the sight distance along the center of the roadway. So it's this part here. So it is also curved. Then we have the R as the radius of center line curve. So this is our R here. And we have the L as the length of the curve. So this is the length of the curve. And we have D as the degree of the curve. Now we have here two conditions. We have the first one, when the sight distance is lesser than the value of the length of the curve, then this will be the figure. And the formula to be used will be M is equal to S squared over 8R. So this is for determining the clear distance from the center of roadway to the obstruction. Now, if the condition is that S is greater than L, then this is our figure, and the formula to be used to compute for the clear distance from center of roadway to the obstruction is M is equal to L parentheses or multiplied by 2S minus L over 8R. So let's solve the three sample problems. The first one, we have here a highway curve with a radius of 80 meters. So given the radius of 80 meters and a length of 90 meters. If the required sight distance is 60 meters, so sight distance is 60 meters, how far off from the center of the road could you allow the bushes to grow? So it's asking for the value of M. So let's look at the value of S and L. We can see that the value of S is equal to 60 is lesser than the value of L. Therefore, we will be using this figure. When S is lesser than L, what will be? Okay, so this is the figure, and the L is greater than S. So as you have observed, we have there the M, which is somewhat the center of the roadway is nearer to the obstruction. Whereas when we are talking about the second condition, S greater than L, the obstruction is farther from the obstruction. Okay, so the formula for S is lesser than L condition is M is equal to S squared over 8R. So we have there M is equal to S squared all over 8R. So we have S equal to 60 squared all over 8 times our R is 80. Therefore, M is equal to 5.625 meters. So that is the distance that you can allow, or this is the limit of the distance you can allow for the bushes to grow. For example, if you have here the bushes, so you will allow it to be 5.625 meters from the center line, not lesser than 5.625, because if you put the bushes somewhat nearer to the roadway, so meaning the obstruction becomes lesser than 5.625, then there will be a problem with the sight distance. So you cannot have a safe traffic or traverse in this portion. So for your traverse to be safer here at this portion, then put your bushes 5.625 meters, at least 5.625 meters from the center line. So that is for example number one. Next, for example number two, the clearance to an obstruction is 40 meters. So clearance to an obstruction, that means it is M. Okay, so the clearance to an obstruction is 40 meters and the desirable sight distance when rounding a horizontal curve is 600 meters. So S is equal to 600 meters. Determine the minimum radius of horizontal curve. So we're looking for radius of the horizontal curve if the length of curve is 550 meters long. So L is equal to 550 meters long. So as you can see, S is greater than L. Therefore, we will be using the figure for S is greater than L. Okay? Now, using that figure, what formula, or using this condition, what formula are we going to use? So we're going to use the formula M. So this one, M is equal to L times 2S minus L over 8R. You can still compute the radius using that formula. We have there M is equal to L times 2S minus L all over 8R. Then the value of M is 40 meters, L is 550, twice of S minus L, 550, oops, all over 8R. Therefore, the value of R here is 1,117.19 meters. Okay. So that is our example number two. So as you can see, in this condition, the obstruction is 40 meters. So S, the sight distance is greater than the length of the curve. Next, the last problem, number three. So there's a building located 5.8 meters from the center line of the inside lane of a curved section of highway with 120 meters radius. So we have there M, clear distance of 5.8 meters from the center line of the inside lane of a curved section of a highway. Given radius is equal to 120 meters. says there the road is level. Perception reaction time is 2.5 seconds. And the coefficient of friction is 0.35. Determine the appropriate speed limit in kilometers per hour considering the stopping site distance. We're looking for the value of B. Now, since you can observe that M here has a small value, so we will have the condition S less than L. Use S is less than L condition. So there you go. You have M equal to S squared over 8R. So one thing about the problem is if we use this, there's no value of S and L. So let's use this portion here, this formula here. So that is M equal to S squared all over 8R. Then the value of M is 5.8 equal to S squared all over 8 times the radius of 120. So S is equal to 74.62 meters. Still, that's not the final answer. Why we're getting the site distance? The reason is we're looking for V. And we can then proceed to the formula for site distance, which is S is equal to VT plus V squared all over 2G times F plus G. Now, the value of S is 74.62 equals to the, there's no V yet, 2.5 for the time, perception reaction time, plus V squared all over twice of gravity. Then the value of friction. So for friction, we have 0.35. Plus, what is the grade of the road? Now, it says here in the problem, the road is level. Therefore, if the road is level, the grade is 0%. So, there's no rise in the slope. So, that is 0%. So, B now is equal to, using our calculators, shift solve. So B is equal to 15.63 meter per second. Now the problem wants the answer for V or the speed limit equal to kilometers per hour. So we will convert this into kilometers per hour. So 1 kilometer divided by 1,000 meters. And then we have 3,600 seconds in 1 hour. So we have there cancel meters, cancel seconds. So B now is equal to 56.27 kilometers per hour. Okay, so that is our number 3. So that ends this video.